favors you fortunate few who witness these feral foes in a furious fray. First, I give you the wild wonder of the Western Kingdoms. Wise men say only fools rush in to face the Wolverine.
No way, it's Logan joining the fight. Oh jeez, I just exploded. Crowd member says, that's a Wolverine? Looks like a rat. Careful, he's got adamantium claws.
But what wily wonder could conceivably win a war against the Wolverine? There is but one answer. That hardy, hate-filled horror, the Honey Badger!
I thought you were gonna say Sabretooth, but... yeah, Honey Badger... you know... what's the saying? Honey Badger don't... care, right? A crowd member says, then that is definitely a squirrel.
I bid the battle begin!
Okay, so that's a rat.
You call this entertainment?
And that's a squirrel.
Cause I don't. Me mum and me dad have had better fights than this over midwinter dinner.
I don't doubt it.
Where's the blood? Where's the furious beauty of the fray? The eternal dance of life and death. The dramatic clash of tooth and claw in an unending battle for survival and supremacy played out before us in the theater of combat.
Yeah. Where is that stuff?
That's good.
Patience, my peculiarly profound patrons. The primitive play you propose will be presented.
Yet with a little work on the alliteration, you could replace Baeloth, that one crowd member. Gods, Baeloth, what are you up to now? Now, from our perspective, we met him very briefly. I think he fell out of the sky. Before I played the Black Pits expansion or additional content, whatever you'd want to call it. It was not our party that fought in the Black Pits, it was another party. So we don't know anything about that, but we did meet him briefly. I think he invited us. He wanted to join our party, we refused. So, we're asking him what he's up to now.
Do I know you?
We did not fight together. We've not met. I'm pretty sure I killed you once. Well, neither. We did meet. I did not kill him. We did not fight together. None of these fit, but I guess we've not met? I don't know.
You flatter me.
Crowd member says, I'm gonna flatten you if this show doesn't improve.
You crave more, you cretinous creatures. The cultured company of canniness and class. I concur. And so I give you... the Goblin!
Is that the one in the cage there? Yes, it is. Who's in there? Ah, night's falling. Seems like we're always in nighttime here. Who's he fighting?
Let me out of here, Drow! Let me out!
You'll have your freedom, my freakish friend. But first, you must fight for it.
Can't zoom in, I want to. Kill it! Kill the goblin, you bloody rat! I thought it was a Wolverine. Shut up!
Maglabia take you, Nightskin, let me out!
Silence, you simpering scullion!
The goblin clearly doesn't want to be here. Release her. Her? Now. I didn't know it was a her.
Think on this a tick, noble one. Have you ever met a goblin that didn't thirst for the thrill of the fray?
I actually have not met many goblins.
Free me, snake.
Baeloth says, shut your slobbering face hole, you sniveling smutch. What the hell is a smutch? Be silent, Drow. I would speak with this goblin.
Recognize your role, you repellent wretch. I am the entertainer. I speak. You watch and applaud. Or remove yourself if you'd rather.
You're alliterating annoyance, exactly. I'll not let you kill a sentient creature for the entertainment of this mob.
I cannot concede to such contemptible, nay, criminal coercion.
I'll concede you, silver hair.
I like it. Oh, casting a spell. What would that do? I can't zoom out now. Who's... Someone's fighting him?
Stop! I surrender!
You summon a monster?
Spectral assault! I give up!
Spectral assault. I can't move the screen or do anything.
My pit of plenty! Pauperized! Made pitiful by a pernicious porcupine of a goblin! What a woeful waste!
It was pitiful long before the goblin did what she did.
We had a deal, Drow. You broke it. I should let the ghosts have you.
Well, I couldn't see these ghosts. A deal?
This worm belly promised children food. Then he caged me. Sent me out to kill or die for pink skin scum.
That voice is really interesting. Is this true, Drow?
Forget this wretched rabble-rouser! What will happen to me, Baeloth Baratil, showman of showmen, entertainer of entertainers?
I don't want him to join our party, no. Send him to the Flaming Fist camp? Really? I mean, for them to help him? Or, I don't want to send him there to bother those people. Bide here a time. If I've need of a showman, I shall return for you. I'll never return for him. Your wish is my carefully considered course of action. I shall be here until I choose not to be. Baeloth will wait near the arena to the northwest. Baeloth, the flamboyant drow sorcerer, offered to be my ally. I turn him down. It's important that I'm able to rely on my allies, and Baeloth is patently unreliable. I can find him again at the pit-fighting area to the northwest. We don't need a sorcerer. We have two mages as it is. A crude but deep hole has been dug in the ground in the center of this clearing.
Ah! Fresh air and the beauty of nature. So, how long do we have to stay out here?
Wooden stakes lining its walls prevent those within from escaping, and the loose dirt and rock from pouring inward. Oh, there's a wild dog in here. A dog pants behind the bars of this flimsy cage. You could probably bend the bars if you want to. Free the dog, it might fight us, but it's only a wild dog.
McKin's my name, of the Grubdoubler clan.
I was gonna talk to you eventually. I am wondering about that. But I am Sapphire. I'm sorry you had to suffer the drow's hospitality. Or inhospitality, as it was.
Been through worse. It's over now.
Thank you. What was that dance you did? Did you actually summon those ghosts that subdued Baeloth?
I'm a shaman. Spirits listen to me. They do what I ask, if I ask right.
That is a useful talent. He can join us. I think we might get rid of Glint because he's kind of redundant. Although Vaconia needs to know more healing spells and such. Before I get rid of Glint, I want to take the stuff off him. At least the stuff that we gave him that he didn't come with. Take some time to recover yourself here. I may return to speak to you again. Until then, farewell.
Yeah, right.
Minsk? Crying?
Minsk, art thou crying?
Minsk has ducked in his eye. I won't miss that little mucker.
The goblin?
Not even a little.
He didn't join us. McKinn waits at the arena to the northwest. This is indeed unexpected. I met a goblin named McKinn, guessing that's how you say it, fighting in Baeloth's pit. She seemed a tenacious sort, but I decided it was too risky to have her in my party. Most goblins don't travel openly because they are so hated and feared. I can find her in the pit fighting area to the northwest. Huh. Wonder if he would have trouble. Well, she waits right here. Let's see if we can free this...
Huh?
This, wild dog.
Yes.
Let's talk to it first. Evidently, the wild dog does have something to say. You bend the bars enough to let the dog slip through. It's remaining here, though. Leading us somewhere. Look at that.
Let's talk more fight.
You want us to follow you, boy? Is that what it is? The dog begins frantically digging in the dirt, exposing something buried. And look! That's a good doggy. Look at that. 234 gold. A fire opal ring. A moon bar gem. A skull. And a broken weapon. Skull of a human. Well, just in case someone's looking for a skull, I'll hold on to it. Yeah, we have this one of these already. I love the music, by the way. Can we let the rat out? That was a good doggy. Very good doggy.
What do you need?
Can I have those potions? You can keep the arrows. Can I have these potions too? And these? I'll actually let you keep the elixir of health. He came with this stuff, bullets of fire, though. We did buy him the leather armor plus two. I think? Oh no, he came with us. We bought leather armor for Safana, I believe. Plus one, yeah. And he came with this stuff. I don't want to leave him completely defenseless. And we don't need these singular arrows. I can't stack them as it is, so they'll just be taking up space.
Time to go?
It is, actually. I'm not sure how to actually have him leave the party, so we'll just have him replaced.
Sword first!
McKin's my name, of the Grubdoubler clan. Been through worse. It's over now.
You seem unlike any other goblin I've yet encountered, McKin. Would you consider joining me? I'm traveling north to face Kalar Argent.
Kalar? The spirits say her soul was pure once. Then it twisted into something else. Yes, I'll come with you.
Sound very calm. That's the most you've said in one time. Removing Glint.
Your companionship is not so grating as I feared.
That shiny woman. Don't like her. McKin has joined my company.
He has not said anything out of politeness, but I know he is unhappy without direction.
Did our reputation go down? Okay, I think so. I heard that sound. I asked you to join my party. I wonder what consequences this will have. Most goblins don't travel openly. I'll have to watch out for her. If I dismiss McKin, she'll wait for me at the Flaming Fist camp.
You want me to leave? Seriously? We were having such a good time together.
Head back to the camp. They need you there more than I do here. You think so? Well, you know better than I would. I'll be off then. Take care. So we can return. He said he wanted to meet somebody at Boroskir Bridge. So maybe we might return for him to, have him do that. Might be some quest for him. Okay. So, as it is, McKin, a level 7 shaman. Detect illusion 48. That's not bad. Fighting styles with axe, quarterstaff, and short bow. True neutral. Okay, so not evil. Good dexterity and constitution. Pretty good intelligence. Very good wisdom. Charisma is actually not bad, especially for a goblin. Alright, so... and has... wait. Really nothing. Grubdoubler's axe plus one. Crudely fashioned, but an effective weapon, this axe has a certain sentimental value to McKim Grubdoubler, who stole it from her father. Though she didn't particularly want to possess the axe herself, she very much wanted it not to be possessed by one of her brothers, most of whom were furious their sister managed to steal it before one of them did. 20% chance per hit of confusing the target for 3 rounds. Save versus spell negates. That's good. 20% chance. Returns to the wielder's hand when thrown. Oh, the throwing axe. Oh, damage type melee or thrown missile, slashing a missile. That's pretty cool. Okay. Alright, 73 total hit points. Kind of wondering. A lot more than Safana, so... I think I'll put her up with Minsk. Maybe I have to level her up first? Alright, so... total... the point's actually 73. Another weapon proficiency. Okay, so she's got 2 more level 3 spells, 4 more level 4 spells, 11 more hit points, lore increased by 2, and she have like an axe now, but I can't increase that. Maybe single weapon style for using the axe in melee. Oh. Priest scroll. Okay. This is different. You may choose one spell to put in your spellbook. These will be the spells that your character currently has knowledge of at the beginning of the game. Specialist mage spells that belong to their school have a green outline on them. You must pick one of those spells before continuing on. Okay, well, we don't have a green outline to anything. We have a yellow outline. Okay, so we already know these then. That's useless. 5 magical berries, each berry restores 1 hit point. Don't make me laugh. Okay, so we're picking 1. We can't undo these, so we can only just pick one more. So out of these... I mean, for me it's up to... I mean, we have plenty... Safana can find traps. That's useless. No alignment. I guess maybe useful in certain situations, but resist fire and cold. Or charm person or mammal. Level 3. Okay, so we have call lightning and summon insects. I'm probably going with cure medium wounds. Okay, so similar to druid then. Invisibility purge is useful as well. As is miscast magic. Let's do cure medium. Level 4. 2 remaining. Okay, they're not choosing anything for us. Animal summoning 1. Call woodland beings. A nymph. The nymph has several priest spells at her disposal and will use them in the best interest of the party. These include mental domination, confusion, and mass cure. Is mass cure like cure poison, or mass, is it like a mass healing? Cause serious wounds. Okay, we're going to cure serious. Death ward. Protects the target from all forms of death magic for the duration of the spell. We use this when fighting beholders. This includes, but is not limited to, disintegrate, power word kill, death spell, and finger of death. One turn per level. But I don't know when we're actually going to be fighting a beholder, although we did come across something that looked just like one a few episodes ago. Neutralize poison or poison. Protection from lightning. Negative plane protection. About cure serious wounds. And call woodland beings. I like the idea of the nymph. When asked about her past, McKinn grunts and says you'll sleep easier if you don't know her story. Eventually, she shares with you that her goblin tribe was a vicious and brutal one. As a shaman, McKinn commanded some degree of respect, but her abilities also brought her a maturity the other goblins lacked. She wanted desperately to escape from the cruelty of her life, but the other goblins valued her abilities too much to let her go. One night, a goblin scouting party came across a deer caught in a thicket of brambles. They killed the animal and carried it triumphantly back to camp. McKinn waited until the others had stuffed themselves on raw meat and fallen into a post-meal stupor, then crept away. She's been on her own ever since and has found herself persecuted by humans at every turn. She joined Baeloth Baratil with the understanding that she would be presented as an exhibit, but not made to actually fight. A promise Baeloth broke the minute the opportunity presented itself. Yeah, she actually didn't know him like we know him. Okay. So welcome, McKinn.
Yeah? What? I will. Do it. I will.
I will. Just want to see something. What happens?
No one will listen to a goblin. But I'll try.
Magic is impressive, but now Minsk leads. Swords for everyone!
Okay.
Sword first.
Oh, we still have to mess with this stone. Let's mess with the stone and then see what's up here, if anything. Runes eroded by time mark one face of this tall stone menhir. Sing at it. The menhir's hum turns discordant and shrill. A stone golem. Okay.
I am yours to command, Ostorn.
You want Boo?
You want me? Whatever you like.
Trouble.
Indeed.
What fine?
You're already a ghost.
You're already a ghost?
Velbon?
Yeah, that was a heavy hit. 32 crushing damage.
What? Huh?
More take
I know, I could use these, but...
I go for the ice boom! Go for the ice!
I need healing.
Yes?
Well, the rest of us aren't attacking, are we?
You want boo?
You're already a ghost.
Stings, doesn't it, evil?
Hells, I missed.
I need what?
Alright, use one.
You're mine now.
₹8,000 experience, though.
There is only one boo. Except no substitutes.
Hurry.
Okay. So knows it memorized all these spells. Okay. So you have Armor of Faith, Blast, Cure Light Wounds, Doom, Entangle, and Spirit Ward for first level spells. And then for second level we have Bark Skin, Flame Blade, Resist Fire and Cold, Slow Poison, and Wreathing Fog. This spell creates a cloud of writhing fog. I think it's writhing fog, right? That chills and hinders anyone within its area other than the caster. Creatures in the fog take 1d3 points of cold damage per round. In addition, there's a 20% chance that they must save versus death or be slowed for one round. Creatures immune to cold damage do not suffer any adverse effects from this spell. Wow. That's interesting. Okay, and we got Call Lightning, Cure Medium Wounds, Spiritual Clarity. The Shaman strengthens a creature's spiritual resolve and purges the creature's mind of negative influences. This spell removes the effects of fear, charm, confusion, and feeble mind from a single creature. I think you're going to be Mint's best friend with this. Summon insects as well. And then fourth level, we call woodland beings. Right, that's the nymph. Although it should be being. Cure serious wounds and spirit fire. Similar to fireball, I suppose. 15-foot radius. Energies gather together from the spirit world and form a pale blue sphere. The shaman can throw the sphere so that it explodes into a burst of ghostly azure flames, which deliver 1d4 points of magic damage per level of the shaman, up to a maximum of 10d4. There's also a 33% chance that every enemy within the area of effect will be afflicted by the doom spell, which is -2 penalty to saves and attack rolls for one turn. A successful save versus spell halves the damage and negates the doom effect. Spirits, fey creatures, elementals, and spectral dead take double damage. Very interesting. Six Cure Light Wounds. Do you not have the others memorized? You're serious here.
Yeah?
Wait. Find traps, detect illusion. Shamanic dance? Huh. I want to put a quick spell here.
Realm of the Dead's more exciting than this.
Oh, thanks. Quick spell doesn't seem to be doing anything.
Realm of the Dead's more exciting than this.
Yeah, Realm of the Dead. Okay. Alright, whatever. Just heal then, I guess. That's funny though, and it has that vocal. Shall we try again?
All right.
Well, not you, necessarily.
What? A simple matter?
Make way! Let's talk more fight!
Can we not interact with it again?
Yes. Fine.
It's the same thing that happened with the other stone. We just can't sing to it anymore. All right.
Yes.
Alright, so let's take a look over here. Wait. Oh, what are you guys doing over here?
I'm watching you.
Huh. Decided to hang out over here again? They were over by the inn. There's nothing here. Okay. So we just have the rest of this to clear out. I guess we'll return to camp and rest up. But we'll do that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.